ஜீவன் முக்தி பிரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்கியம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஜீவன் முக்தி பிரதம் தேவம் க்ஷமாபூர்ணம் ஜகத்குரும் வந்தே பரமஹம் சாக்கியம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோக நிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். ஆனந்தானுபவாஸ்வாதம் சர்வரோக நிவாரகம் வந்தே பாப விநாசக்தம் நித்யானந்தாய ஸ்வாகதம். நித்யமுக்தம் நிர்விகல்பம் தியானலோக பிரதீபகம்.
பரமஹம்ச நித்யானந்தா ఈ శతాబ్దపు మరువలేని పోలికలేని ఒక ఆధ్యాత్మిక శక్తి, ఒక అంతర్జాతీయ సాంఘిక ఆధ్యాత్మిక ప్రభంజనాన్ని స్థాపించిన ఒక అద్భుత శక్తి, వైదిక ధర్మాన్ని పునరుద్ధరించడానికి ఉద్భవించిన ఒక చైతన్య శక్తి. ఆయన అతి పవిత్రమైన తిరువణ్ణామలై క్షేత్రంలో జన్మించారు. ఒక యోగిగా జన్మించి తనలో సహజంగానే పొంగిపొరలే ఆధ్యాత్మికతను కోట్ల మందికి పంచుతూ స్ఫూర్తినిచ్చే ఒక అమోఘ శక్తి. అతి పురాతనమైన యోగా విద్యలో ప్రావీణ్యం కలిగి ఆధ్యాత్మిక శాస్త్రాన్ని క్షుణ్ణంగా పరిశోధన చేసిన ఒక మహాద్భుతమైన అంతఃప్రపంచపు పరిశోధకులు, ఆత్మజ్ఞానాన్ని ప్రసాదించే గురువులు. ప్రతి సంవత్సరం పరమహంస నిత్యానంద ఆయన జ్ఞానామృతాన్ని, ఆనందం వెదజల్లే ఆయన చిరునవ్వుని, తిరుగులేని ఆయన దీక్ష యొక్క శక్తిని 1 కోటికి పైగా ఉన్న ఆయన శిష్యులకు పంచుతున్నారు. ఇప్పుడు పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మీరు జీవన్ముక్తులుగా జీవించటానికి తోడ్పడే పరిష్కారాలను మీకు అందజేస్తున్నారు. ఒక మరువలేని ఆధ్యాత్మిక అనుభవం కొరకు మమ్మల్ని వెంటనే సంప్రదించండి.
వేద వేదాంత సంవేద్యం దేవదేవీ స్వరూపిణం వందే వటపలాశిస్థం.
Let me give you some of the sacred secrets. What is your belief? Belief is nothing but the words and ideas and truths put inside you, whom you believe will not harm you. When some ideas, beliefs have been put inside you by your parents or friends or relatives whom you trust will not think bad for you, will do only good for you, those ideas are only becoming belief in you. That is why friendliness plays such a major component in teaching. But unfortunately, after a certain level, friendliness cannot help in teaching. To make you comfortable in the same spectrum you are living is different. Raising you completely to the different spectrum is different. When you need to be raised completely to the different spectrum, the ideas which got into your system, which was given to you by the deep friendliness by your friends or relatives or family, will not be sufficient, because they may not think bad for you, but what they think as a good itself has its own limitations. They cannot think even in the line of good, auspiciousness, right, beyond certain level. If a beggar thinks all good should happen to you, what he will imagine? You should have enough food and a house to rest. Nobody should ask you work. For a beggar, this is ultimate, over. He is not going to think, let you become enlightened. You go to a temple, you come out, and on the way there is a beggar, you give him some 100 rupees, and suddenly he is shocked by 100 rupees, because nobody gives him more than 1 rupee, and he sees 100 rupees, and this guy immediately want to give his gratitude to you. He blesses, let you have all good things. So what do you think he will be visualizing in the mind? plates and plates of food and a comfortable house, freedom, so that nobody will ask you to work. That's all he can think. Understand, he cannot visualize enlightenment and tell you, let you have enlightenment. No, that's not going to happen. So the very thinking, see, it is not that beggar wants any good, bad for you. He wants only good. Even that he can imagine or think only to a certain level. All your beliefs, ideas are nothing but people who think good for you, but who are good for nothing. They think good for you, but they themselves are good for nothing. They are good for only to the level an ordinary logic can function. If he is little intelligent man, he will say, all right, not only food and the house, let him have health also. Let him have a little bank balance also. Let him have a good wife. That much he can think. Not further. The beliefs, ideas, you think good for you, put by the people who are good for nothing, is only now fighting when the master tries to teach you something. It is the remains of your parents and family and society and school which is sitting in you, is fighting with the reminder by existence. Master is a reminder to you by existence. Come back home. For a long time you are out. Get back. Is a reminder to you from the existence. Unfortunately, remains of the society in you fights the reminder. Here, reminder comes down to the level of the remains of the society in you. Bhagavan is not even saying, I wanted to impose something newly on you. Let me come down. What you feel as a good, what you feel as a right, what you believe, what has got into your system by the people whom you don't suspect. When your friend says, hey, study well, get a job, naturally, he is not thinking bad for you. But the fool can think only that much. Many times, the idea is put inside your head by the people who don't think bad for you does not mean always those ideas are good for you. Bhagavan says, all right, whatever is said and done, all those ideas from the friends, family, society has gone into your system and became a biomemory, like a calculus. It has settled in your system. Now, it may be difficult for you to clear that. Let me come down to your level. Whatever ideas you already believe, which is put inside you by society, let me work with those ideas and liberate you, give you the truth. O Bharata, all life forms are unmanifest initially. Very beautifully, Bhagavan is using the word. Life forms.
కల్పతరు మీలోని కుండలిని శక్తిని తెలుసుకోగల ఒక ప్రత్యేక కార్యక్రమము కల్పతరు. పూర్తిగా ఒకరోజు జరిగే ఈ కార్యక్రమములో ఆరోగ్యకరమైన అద్భుతమైన మార్పును పొందగలరు. అవతార మూర్తి పరమహంస నిత్యానంద స్వామి వారి ఆశీస్సులను ప్రత్యేకంగా పొందగల కార్యక్రమం కల్పతరు. కుండలిని అంటే ఏమిటి? కుండలిని అంటే ప్రతి ఒక్కరిలోనూ దాగి ఉన్న అద్భుత శక్తి. కుండలిని శక్తి ఒక ధ్యానోదయమైన గురుదేవుల దీక్షతో చైతన్యపరచవచ్చు. ఈ కుండలిని శక్తి మీ జీవితంలో అన్ని దశలలోనూ అభివృద్ధికరమైన మార్పులను తేగలిగే శక్తి. అది మీలో ఆరోగ్యాన్ని, ఐశ్వర్యాన్ని, విజయాన్ని, ఆనందాన్ని, ఆధ్యాత్మిక ధ్యానోదయాన్ని కలిగిస్తుంది. ప్రతి వారాంతములో కల్పతరు కార్యక్రమం బిడిది ఆశ్రమంలో నిర్వహించబడును. మమ్మల్ని సంప్రదించవలసిన చిరునామా: నిత్యానంద ధ్యానపీఠం, నిత్యానంద నగర్, బిడది 562109, బెంగళూరు. ఫోన్ చేయవలసిన నంబరు 09555000550 లేదా 09618519701. మా వెబ్సైట్ www.nityananda.org.
ಲಿಂಗಂ ನಿರ್ಮಲ ಭಾಷಿತ ಶೋಭಿತ ಲಿಂಗಂ ಜನ್ಮಜ ದುಃಖ ವಿನಾಶಕ ಲಿಂಗಂ ಜನ್ಮಜ ದುಃಖ ವಿನಾಶಕ ಲಿಂಗಂ ತತ್ ಪ್ರಣಮಾಮಿ ನಿತ್ಯಾನಂದ ಲಿಂಗಂ.
ಓಂ ನಮೋ ಭಗವತೆ ರುದ್ರಾಯ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ರುದ್ರಮಣ್ಯವ ಕುತೋ ದಯಿಷವೇ ನಮಃ ನಮಸ್ತೆ ಅಸ್ತು ಧನ್ವನೆ ಬಾಹುಭ್ಯಾಮೃತೇ ನಮಃ ಯಾಚಯಿಷು ಶಿವತಮಾ ಶಿವಂ ಬಭೂವತೇ ಧನುಃ ಶಿವ ಶರವ್ಯಾಯ ತಮತಯಾ ನೋ ರುದ್ರ ಮೃಡಯ ಯಾ ದೇ ರುದ್ರ ಶಿವ ತನೋರ ಘೋರ ಪಾಪಕಾಶಿನಿ ತಯಾ ನಸ್ತನು ಆಶಂತಮಯ ಗಿರಿಶಂತ ವಿಚಾಗಶೀಹಿ ಯಾಮಿಷುಂ ಗಿರಿಶಂತ ಹಸ್ತೆ ವಿಭಷ್ಟ್ಯಸ್ತವೇ ಶಿವಾಂ ಗಿರಿ ಕೃತಾಂ ಗುರು ಮಾಹಿ ಪುಂಸಿ ಪುರುಷಂ ಜಗತ್ ಶಿವೇನ ವಚಸಾ ತ್ವಾ ಗಿರಿಶಾಚ್ಛಾ ವದಾಮಸಿ ಯಥಾ ನಃ ಸರ್ವಮಿಜ್ಜಗದ ಯಕ್ಷ್ಮಗುಂ ಸುಮನ ಅಸದ್ ಅದ್ಯ ವೋಚದಿ ಭಕ್ತ ಪ್ರಥಮೋ ದೈವ್ಯೋ ಋಷಗೆ ಅಹೀಭಿಶ್ಚ ಸರ್ವಾನ್ ಜಂಬಯನ್ ಸರ್ವಾಶ್ಚ ಯಾದು ಧಾನ್ಯಃ ಅಸೌ ಯಸ್ತಾಮ್ರೋ ಅರುಣಪುತ ಭಭ್ರಸ್ವ ಮಂಗಲಃ ಯೇ ಚೇಮಾಗುಂ ರುದ್ರ ಅಮಿತೋ ದಿಕ್ಷು ಶ್ರುತಾ ಸಹಸ್ರಶೋ ವೈ ಶಾಗುಂ ಭೇಡಯೀಮಹೇ ಅಸವ್ಯೋ ವಸತ್ಪತಿ ನೀಲಗ್ರೀವೋ ವಿಲೋಹಿತಃ ಉದೈನಂ ಗೋಪಾ.
He is not using life. Life forms. All life forms are unmanifest initially. Then in the middle, they become manifest. And finally, become imperceivable once again. Then what lamenting can be there regarding this? All of you have assumed your body with certain purpose. Nobody can destroy that purpose. Even if they try to destroy this body, the purpose is so powerful, it will assume one more body and do the job. All you need to do is stop grieving. There is nothing to lament. Bhagavan is coming back to straightening Arjuna's own logic without adding any new component or new word or new truth into it. As Arjuna is in the confused seeker state, he may not be able to digest or internalize new truths, new components, new ideas. So Bhagavan is now using a method of straightening out his own logic. There are many things he strongly believes. With those basic concepts itself, Bhagavan is trying to eliminate the suffering and confusion from Arjuna. He feels it is too much for Arjuna to grasp new words, new ideas, new truths. It may not go well. It may not be easy for Arjuna to digest something new now. Best is clearing the confusions with which he is suffering. Logic needs to be cleared, clarified. Bhagavan comes down and talks to Arjuna. With the ideas, truths, concepts, Arjuna is already familiar, or already accepting, or already believing, already in tune with. O Partha, do not grieve. Now he is using the word Paridevana. Actually, this word Paridevana is a little more strong word. It's more like a Paridapa, sympathy. Too poor. Bhagavan is actually teasing Arjuna, even in your suffering, you have gone to the lowest point. చీప్ సఫరింగ్. సంబడి హస్ స్టోలన్ వన్ స్మాల్ డైమండ్ ఫ్రమ్ ద ట్రెషరీ అండ్ ద కింగ్ ఈస్ డిప్రెస్డ్ ఫర్ దాట్ అండ్ ఈ డి నాట్ అటెండ్ దిస్ కోర్ట్ అండ్ ఆఫీస్ ఫర్ 2 డేస్ ఇన్ ద డిప్రెషన్ ఈస్ లయింగ్ ఆన్ ద బెడ్. వాట్ అ చీప్ సఫరింగ్. ఇఫ్ యూ అటెండ్స్ ద కోర్ట్ హీ విల్ మేక్ మోర్ డైమండ్స్ లైక్ దట్. ఈవెన్ ఇన్ సఫరింగ్ దర్ ఇస్ సంథింగ్ కాల్డ్ చీప్ సఫరింగ్. దట్ ఈస్ వాట్ ఈస్ పరిదేవన. నాట్ ఓన్లీ సీ ఈవెన్ నాను శోచితం అర్హసి. ఇన్ దట్ వర్డ్ శోచితం వాట్ భగవాన్ మీన్స్ అ సఫరింగ్ ఏ కైండ్ ఆఫ్ డీసెంట్ సఫరింగ్. ఫర్ ఎగ్జాంపుల్ యు లివ్డ్ విత్ సంబడి యువర్ క్లోజ్ ఫ్రెండ్ ఆర్ అ స్పౌస్ ఆర్ సంబడి ఫ్రమ్ ఫ్యామిలీ దట్ పర్సన్ డైస్ అండ్ యు ఆర్ గ్రీవింగ్ దట్ క్యాన్ బి కాల్డ్ అస్ శోచితం. లిటిల్ డీసెంట్ వర్డ్ హియర్ ద వర్డ్ భగవాన్ ఈస్ యూజింగ్ పరిదేవన ఈస్ లైక్ ఎ చీప్ సఫరింగ్. సంబడి హస్ స్టోలన్ యువర్ చెప్పల్ బికాస్ ఆఫ్ దట్ ఫర్ 10 డేస్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ వాకింగ్ లయింగ్ ఆన్ ద బెడ్ నాట్ పుట్టింగ్ ద ఫుట్ ఆన్ ద గ్రౌండ్ సేయింగ్ ఐ ఆమ్ మిస్సింగ్ మై చెప్పల్ ఐ విల్ నాట్ పుట్ మై ఫీట్ ఆన్ ద గ్రౌండ్ అన్లెస్ ఐ గెట్ మై చెప్పల్ ఐఎమ్ గోయింగ్ టు ఫాస్ట్ అండ్ టు డెత్. చీప్ సఫరింగ్. భగవాన్ ఈస్ యాక్చువల్లీ టీజింగ్. He may be looking very sincere in his words, but in his eyes, he is just boiling. You idiot. I have to sit here and waste so much of time. These are the words I can get out of these verses when I read between the lines. When I read between the lines, I can tell you very clearly the sacred secrets hiding in this sutra. If I had to read exactly, you idiot, get out of this depression and come out and start the war. I have so much work. Let's finish and go back. But the problem is sometimes you can't shout at the disciples because you groomed them, trained them for a purpose. Almost that purpose is about to be done. And this Vedala has gone up again. Like a Vikramaditya story, Vedala going up only is the ego going up on the top of your head and sitting. And the Vedala goes up, what to do?
Oka avatara purushuni divya salahanu neruga pondalanukuntunnara? Ippudu meeku paramahamsato mukhamukhi.
Nityanandam, Nityananda here.
పరమహంస నిత్యానంద మరొక్కసారి పోలిక లేని ఒక విభిన్నమైన కానుకను ప్రపంచానికి
అందచేస్తున్నారు.
ఆయన ఇప్పుడు ప్రతిరోజు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం అయ్యే సత్సంగంలో మీ ప్రశ్నలకి జవాబు ఇవ్వడానికి సిద్ధముగా ఉన్నారు. ఉదయం 8 గంటలకు మా నంబరు 0808-27-99-99 ఫోన్ చేసే అదృష్టవంతులకు ఆయనతో నేరుగా మాట్లాడే దివ్యమైన అవకాశం దక్కుతుంది. మరియు ఉదయం ప్రత్యక్ష ప్రసారం అయ్యే సత్సంగం ntv.nityananda.org లో చూడగలరు.
Nothing can be done. So you have to sit and pacify the Vedala, sing bhajans for the Vedala, then it will slowly come down. You have to catch and start your journey. That's why Bhagavan comes down and says, hey, even with the logic, you understand, you believe, look. The beautiful thing with Bhagavad Gita is, it's a straight, beautiful sentence. A guru can sit and repeat that word, a disciple can directly understand and meditate. Before your birth, what was your face? Try to paint. You don't know. It was unmanifest. After your last rites, what is going to be your face? You don't know. Only in the middle, they became manifest. So what is the reason to lament? Why suffering? And such a cheap way, this whole what you are seeing was not there in the beginning, will not be there in the end. In the middle, it is appearing. Why are you suffering for it? Why are you worrying about it? Why are you being lamented for it? Please understand, anything which comes in the middle, if it adds joy to you, allow it in your life. Otherwise, just tell them, get out. I tell you, small fellows should not give suffering for you. If you allow the small fellows to give suffering for you, it's too much. Small story. An old man who is a truck driver was sitting in a truck stop and eating when three dangerous looking bikers walked in, young fellows looking dangerous. The first walked up to the old man, pushed his cigarette and took a seat at the counter. The second walked up to the old man, spit on his face and took his seat. The third walked up to the old man, just kicked him, turned over the old man's plate, and then he took the seat. Without a word of protest, the old man quietly left the hotel. Shortly thereafter, one of the bikers said to the waitress, "See what kind of a man he is. Not much of a man, was he?" The waitress replied, "Yes, sir, not much of a truck driver either. He just backed his truck over three motorcycles." Don't allow cheap fellows to give suffering for you. So old man took care, the cheap fellows don't give suffering for him. Many times, dangerous looking bikers enter your life. Don't allow cheap fellows to give suffering for you. Don't allow this world to give suffering for you. Whatever you see, perceive, imagine, these three are the bikers. What you see, what you hear, what you imagine. What you see and what you hear is the base material. And with these two, you cook up. That is what you imagine. These three are the three bikers constantly entering your life when you are eating. One kicks your plate, one spits on you, one throws stone on you. Silently go out, back your truck. World is too cheap to cause suffering for you. Don't be grieved. Don't allow the suffering by the world in your life. What lamenting can be there regarding this? Bhagavan is saying very clearly, whatever even you believe, based on that logic, let me talk to you. I am not introducing new words, new ideas, new truths, no. You already know from the parents, from the society, whatever you are seeing did not have form earlier, will not have the form after, it is only appearing now. Then, why are you letting this suffer, give suffering to you? Sometimes, some words can create a strong experience in you. For example, if you are connected closely with somebody and that person is dead, and if somebody else reminds you, even words used by those person, who is close friend, part of your life, you will suddenly get into the mood, experience of that person. Some tries to visualize it, some tries to speak about it, another hears of it as a wonder, yet having heard, none understands it at all, is describing about the ultimate truth. These words of Bhagavan are more like finger pointing to the moon. It is just pointing to the pure truth. These words are uttered with such a precise clarity and authority, I am just lost in that experience. Taittiri Upanishad says, failing to reach which words turn back along with the mind. Brahma is the word, Vishnu is the mind. Both of them fail to reach, head or feet of Mahadeva and reach back. Bhagavan is describing now the impossibility to know it by ordinary senses. How can a confused mind perceive? Bhagavan is saying, oh fool, with this mentality which you are having now, you will not be able to perceive it. Why don't you just relax? Why don't you just come down? Why don't you just rest? You can't talk about silence. I can't say much about unspeakable. I only can say it is unspeakable, that's all. If I go on saying more and more words, then I am trying to speak on unspeakable. It's like talking to somebody who is already lost in some dreams. I can give you some references, crass references. Katopanishad says, of that self which is not available for the mere hearing to many, and which many do not understand even while hearing, the expounder is wonderful and the receiver is wonderful. Wonderful is he who knows under the instruction of an adept. Here again, the impossibility of the description of ultimate truth is explained by Bhagavan. Bhagavan comes very clearly. He comes out very clearly in this verse. It's not possible to grasp by the senses. No question you'll be able to grasp by confused mind. Sit and contemplate for a few minutes. What is that which cannot be spoken, which cannot be visualized, which only has to be realized?
To reach at least 1 lakh people per day.